This place is bread paradise. I'm so excited.
Mexico City's bakery tradition goes back a few centuries. Every neighborhood has a panaderia or bakery. In fact, there are more bakeries in Mexico City than grocery stores or gas stations. In this video, we are going to be heading down to our neighborhood panaderia and we'll find out how a country that loves corn also came to love and accept bread.
Ruchi here, and we just made a trip to one of Mexico City's oldest bakery, Pastaleria Ideal. We picked up a lot of Mexican breads that we wanted to try, and they packed it in this. Isn't the packaging so old school, and it's so cute? I remember in India when I was a kid, some of the places, especially sweet shops and bakeries, used to pack things like this. I can imagine this package has a lot of nostalgia for Mexicans. Imagine coming home and feeling so happy seeing this package at the kitchen table. I would be really excited for what's inside. Bread is sold everywhere in Mexico City. There are so many panaderias in the city, from local neighborhood round the corner ones to high-end ones. People even have a bread guy that you can call when your supply of bread is running low. Like, get that bread. Okay, just trying to open this. One of my favorite things about this bakery was the amount of grandmas and grandpas shopping. It's so cute to see them shop. I'm sure some lucky grandkids are going to get some really delicious treats today.
Wow, that packaging looks so amazing.
It does, right? The Spanish arrived in Mexico in the 1500s. They brought the European staple wheat with them. Not only because wheat was the European staple, but also because wheat had a religious significance. But how did bread become as important to the Mexicans as tortillas? When the Spanish were here, a viceroy dipped a piece of the bread into the local hot chocolate. Can you imagine watching someone dip bread into hot chocolate for the very first time? It just became the start of a habit for Europeans and Latin Americans. Even today, people across Europe and Latin America love to dip their bread into hot coffee or hot chocolate. In a couple of years, the demand for bread started to increase. The rich aristocrat classes brought in fancy French bakers. They made this French baguette, which here is called a bolillo. It's the same technique as the French baguette. It's crispy on the outside and soft on the inside. They also started making brioches, which serves as a base for the Mexican sweet bread concha. And by the 19th century, bread had become an important part of every Mexican household, just like tortillas. But more important than plain regular bread are the sweet breads, or pan dulces. The most popular of the pan dulces, the concha. Conchas are popular all over Mexico and even in the US and Latin America, wherever Mexicans have immigrated, it's traveled with them. Concha is basically a bread roll topped with a crumbly cookie crust. It's basically a brioche style bread which was brought here by the French bakers. And first the bread roll is made and then the cookie crust is made separately. And then when it's ready to be baked, they top it with the cookie crust and then bake it. So once they lay the cookie crust on top of the bread dough, they make this crisscross pattern, which makes the bread resemble a shell or a conch, and that's why it's called the concha. The bread is not usually flavored, but the cookie crust always has some sort of flavor like sugar or vanilla or chocolate or condensed milk. I've even seen hipster bakeries do versions with matcha or raisin cinnamon and things like that. So earlier versions of the concha were flavored with a local unrefined sugar which is called piloncillo. And Indians will recognize piloncillo as jaggery. We still use jaggery in India today, and Latin America will recognize it as panela sugar. It's not clear who added the sugary crust on top of the concha. Chances are it was added by the Spanish to make the local population accept wheat as the staple instead of corn. Now there is a similar type of concha in the absolute other side of the world in China and Japan. There is melon pan in Japan and the pineapple bun or bo lao bao in China. It's quite possible that these creations were influenced by Europe both in the East and here in Mexico. I'd love to discuss this with a bread history expert, but enough history for now. Let's taste this concha. The cookie crust is perfectly crumbly, and as you can see, I'm making a mess. But if it's not crumbly, that means you've got yourself a bad concha. The crumbliness is both the delight and the annoyance of eating the concha. I really like it. I just want some coffee to dunk it into. Next up is the cuerno. It's called cuerno because it's based on the French croissant. It's a lighter version of the croissant because it doesn't use as much butter and sugar. And it's called cuerno because it's shaped like the bull's horns. But it's also called bijote because it's shaped like a mustache. Depends on what way you look at it. Ah, thank you. It's nothing like a croissant actually. It's way lighter and airier than a croissant, but croissants also have like this very soft buttery flaky feel which this doesn't have. It's different. I like it. It's a dense chunky bread. I respect this. This is a bolillo. As I mentioned before, it's a French baguette. It's crispy on the outside and soft on the inside, and they use this to make the torta or the Mexican sandwich. It's really good.
Alright, so Ruchi was eating a lot, so I wanted in on the action. This is called an oreja. It's inspired by the French pamir. I've seen this in India also in some of the bakeries. I think these little hearts in India was the small version of these. French named it pamirs because it resembles the palm leaf, but here they call it the oreja, which means elephant ear. Like this, I guess. Mm-hmm. Like this. Right. So good. It's light, it's flaky, it crumbles in your mouth once you take the bite, and there's a sugar layer on top of it, so it tastes really good. Next up is pancake. So this is a pound cake. I think this is the most common cake which we have all had growing up. We have this in India also. This is the most simplest style of cake. It just has egg, dough, sugar and butter.
The magic words. Yeah. Yep.
Okay, so I see that this one specifically has two layers. I think this is chocolate layered. Let me taste it. There is a chocolate layer on top, and then there is that plain cake here. So let's dive in. This is so good. Anyone who likes plain cake will love this.
Look who's here.
There you go.
Iyengar bakery cake.
That's the best description I can give for all the Indian viewers out there. So the next one is a weird looking one. So that's why we picked it up. It's called Ojo de Buey. So basically it is a sweet biscuit dough in the center. They make a big crate of the sweet biscuit, this one, and cut it out in circles and layer it around with layers of puff pastry. So this is crunchy and this should be soft. That at least that's what I'm expecting when I bite into this. So let's see. It is called Ojo de Buey, which literally translates to eye of the ox or eye of the bull. Look at it.
It doesn't look like an eye of the ox to me.
You should have some imagination, Ruchi. Right?
Like, I hope it doesn't taste like that.
This is a very familiar taste. I can't place it yet. I know we have something like this in India. The puff pastry is crunchy and the biscuit is soft. It's nice. It's not fantastic like the panque. I would buy another panque rather than this. Maybe we are missing something about how we should be eating this. I guess we should be eating this with something. Okay, the next up is mantecada. This looks very familiar. So this was bought here by the Spanish. This is based on a Spanish baking technique. This is very popular. We saw like people carrying crates and crates of this in the bakery. I can see why.
Tea time cake.
Yeah. All the little cupcakes with little icings, they get all the attention and Instagram likes.
But this guy is the real star. So we have three more to go.
This is something we just bought, we just bought it because we saw so many people buying it. Like, they were stacking this up. People were buying 10, 15 of these.
It seems it's very popular.
Yeah.
So we wanted to try it. And so we asked someone, what is this called?
It's called rebanada mantequilla, which basically means bread, butter, sugar. It's the simplest white bread. And it's white butter, it's not salted butter that we use on toast. And it's just powdered sugar on top.
Mm. I'd say it's why it's popular.
Yeah.
It's like, again, I'm getting, if I want to reference my childhood of what I was eating in Indian bakeries, it's like cream bun. Mm.
Iyengar Bakery cream bun.
Iyengar Bakery cream buns. Oh, I see. Huh, Mexicans and Indians have same taste.
Yeah, very similar taste.
That's what we have been observing since we came to Mexico. We have the same taste, same flavors, yet the food is so different.
Mm. This is called Maranita or Cochito because it looks like a pig. Cochito means pig. Maranita also has pig references. And it feels very spongy. It looks like a cookie.
Is it spongy? I thought it would be like very hard.
It feels, yeah, it looks hard, but it feels very doughy.
Yeah.
It's basically cookie dough, and then it gets this brownish color from cinnamon and piloncillo sugar.
Again, they use jaggery.
They mix it into the dough before baking it.
So it's like a jaggery biscuit.
Yeah.
Oh. There is no snap. It isn't hard. It's actually very soft. I got his leg.
You broke his leg. Oh my god. Mm. This is so familiar.
Oh wow. Oh wow.
This is like Indian atta biscuit.
Yeah. The ones we eat with chai in that local roadside shops.
I've not seen them so popular in the south, but atta biscuit is like a thing in the north. We used to buy so much atta biscuit.
We grew up eating atta biscuit also.
Yeah, it's a thing,
but it's not, people don't buy it for homes. It's available in little shops where they sell the cigarettes and
small,
those
little cigarette and banana shops.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I wish there was some savory in this. This is sweet. It's actually on the plainish side, but
the
it has some sweet in it.
The Indian one, they have these striations on top.
Yes.
So
it this is like Good Day biscuit.
No.
No.
Good Day sucks.
Good Day doesn't suck.
Good Day doesn't suck. Sponsored. Get in touch with us, Good Day.
Yeah.
Okay, the last one. I hope we saved the best for the last. This is called Beso. Beso means kiss in Spanish. It looks like these two cookies are kissing. That's nasty. Stop. It's a clean, good-natured kiss. And they are basically, they are two yeast cookies. They feel spongy. And
okay.
Yeah.
Oh. Nice.
And inside is whipped cream, but I've seen several with different types of kissing filling, jam, strawberry jam, and their apricot jam is really popular here. So, let's separate them. You will never be together again.
Okay, I'll take this.
I love the cream. It's very light, airy, whipped cream, lots of sugar, and I think it has orange zest. I can taste some zesty.
I wish the bread was this bread instead of the cupcake type bread.
Then it would be like a sandwich.
No, they could shape it like this, right?
Yeah, but this is a kiss.
Yeah.
That's a sandwich.
That's all the things we got from Pastaleria Ideal.